Good morning children. In the last video we have discussed about balanced chemical equation. Today we can study how can we balance a chemical equation. What are the steps involved in balancing of chemical equation? Now we can study what are the steps involved in balancing of chemical equations. Write the balanced chemical equation for the following reaction. The chemical reaction given here is steam is passed over red hot iron to form oxide of iron and hydrogen. Steam is passed over red hot iron to form oxide of iron. Its formula is given here, Fe3O4. That is the oxide of iron formed. Along with that, hydrogen also produced. This is the chemical reaction taking place. We have to balance the equation of this chemical reaction. If a reaction is given like this, first we have to write the word equation of this reaction. How can we write the word equation? We have to write the reactants in the left hand side and the product in the right hand side. Which are the reactants in this equation, in this reaction? Steam is passed over red hot iron. So steam is one of the reactant and iron is the other reactant. So iron reacting with the steam. What is steam? Steam is the gaseous form of water. Okay. Iron is reacting with the steam to form oxide of iron. Oxide of iron, it's a, that we can write like this, iron oxide and hydrogen. That is the second product. So we can put a plus sign, hydrogen. So in this equation, in this reaction, iron and steam are the reactants. Iron oxide and hydrogen are the product. So this is the word equation of this given chemical reaction. This is the first step, step 1. Okay. Then next we have to convert this word equation into chemical equation using the symbols and formula of this reactants and product. That is the second step. Step 2. What is the symbol of iron? Fe. Then steam. Steam is the gaseous form of water. So its formula is same, H2O. H2O gives iron oxide. Its formula is given in the question itself. So we can write Fe3O4 plus hydrogen. What is the formula? H2. So this is the skeletal equation of the given chemical reaction. After writing this skeletal equation, what we have to do? We have to put this reactants and product in boxes. Now, we are not supposed to make any changes inside these boxes. We can add numbers outside the boxes in order to balance this chemical equation. Okay. Then in step 3, we have to list the number of atoms of different elements present in the skeletal equation. So for that we have to make a table. The first column, element. Which elements are present in the equation, that we have to write like this. Then number of atoms of each element on the left hand side and on the right hand side. Then here three elements are there, iron, hydrogen, oxygen. These are the three elements present in this equation. Here also iron, oxygen and hydrogen. So in this equation three elements are there. They are iron, hydrogen and oxygen, that we have to write in the first column. Then we have to write how many iron atoms are present in the left hand side. How many iron atoms are there? If there is no number in the left hand side of that element, that means it is 1. Okay. If we are not writing any number in this left hand side, that means it is 1. So here there is no number, that means only one iron atom is present in the left hand side. So that we have to write here 1. Okay. Then how many iron atoms are present on the right hand side? Fe3. That means 3 iron atoms are there in the right hand side. Okay. So here we have to write 3. Then next element is hydrogen. How many hydrogen atoms are present on the left hand side? H2O. That means 2 hydrogen atoms are there. So on the left hand side 2 hydrogen atoms. Then what about on the right hand side? Here also 2 hydrogen atoms. Okay. Then what about oxygen? Here there is no number. No number, that means its number is 1. Okay. So only 1 oxygen atom is present in the left hand side, that we have to write here. And in the product side, that is on the right hand side, 4 oxygen atoms are there. So that we have to write here 4. Okay. So this is the step 3. we have to list the number of atoms of different elements present in the given chemical equation. Now step 4 is we have to select the biggest formula and balancing the element with the highest number of atoms. In this equation we have to select which reactant or product has the biggest formula. Which is having biggest formula? Fe3O4. It contains more number of atoms, isn't it? Here only 1 atom. Here only 2 plus 1, 3 atom. Here 3 plus 4, 7 atoms are there. And here only 2 atoms. So this is the formula which contains more number of atoms. So that one we have to select. Then we have to balance the element which contain more number of atoms. Here 2 elements are there, iron and oxygen. Which contain more number of atom? Oxygen. It contain more number of atoms. 4 atoms are there. So we have to balance the number of oxygen atom first. Okay. Since oxygen has more number of atoms, we can balance the number of oxygen atom first. For that we are writing again the element oxygen. Left hand side it contain only 1 oxygen atom. Right hand side 4 oxygen atoms are there. So in left hand side there is a deficiency of oxygen atom. Balancing the number of oxygen atom means on both sides the number should be equal. How can we make these numbers equal? For that we have to multiply this left hand side with 4. 1 into 4 equal to 4. So the left hand side we have to multiply with 4. So that both sides become equal. The number of oxygen atom on both sides become equal. Okay. So when we are multiplying this left hand side, where we have to write this 4? That we can include in this equation like this. In the left hand side, we have to multiply with 4. When we are multiplying with 4, the reactant which contains oxygen atom should be multiplied with 4. This is the reactant which contains oxygen atom. So that reactant should be multiplied with 4. Okay. So here outside this box, we have to write 4. Okay. So now our equation becomes Fe plus 4H2O gives Fe3O4 plus H2. So when we are multiplying here with 4, the number of oxygen atom becomes 4 on the left hand side. And it is already 4 on the right hand side. So the number of oxygen atom become equal on both sides. So its number is balanced. Now next element. Which is the next element contain more number of atom? That is iron. In the right hand side it contains 3 iron atom, but in the left hand side only 1 iron atom. So we have to make it equal on both sides. How can we make it equal? That is the next step. Step 5. Again we have to make a table. We are balancing the number of iron atoms. So we can write only iron atoms. Okay. The element is iron. On the left hand side 1 iron atom and on the right hand side 3 iron atoms are there. We have to make it equal. How can we make it equal? For that we have to multiply the left hand side with 3. Then only it will become equal, isn't it? So 1 into 3 equal to 3. So the left hand side we have to multiply with 3. As a result the number of iron atom on the left hand side and right hand side become equal. So when we are multiplying with 3 on the left hand side, where we have to write that 3? Reactant. Near to the reactant which contain iron atom. So here the first reactant which is iron atom. There we have to multiply with 3. That means outside this box we have to write 3. So our equation becomes 3 into Fe plus 4H2O gives Fe3O4 plus H2. Then don't forget to put the boxes. So when we are multiplying this side with 3, the number of iron atom become 3 on the left hand side. The right hand side also 3. So the number of iron atom become equal on both sides. Now which is the next element we have to balance? Yes, that is hydrogen. Here at first the number of hydrogen atom was equal on both sides. On the left hand side 2, on the right hand side also it was 2. But when we are making the number of oxygen atom equal, here we have multiplied with 4. So what is the total number of hydrogen atom? 4 into 2, 8. The number of hydrogen atom becomes 8 on the left hand side, but here on the right hand side it is only 2. So we have to make it equal. That is our next step, that is step 6. So again we have to make a table in which we have to write the element hydrogen. On the left hand side 4 into 2, 8 hydrogen atoms are there, but on the right hand side only 2 hydrogen atom. So we have to make it equal. How can we make it equal? On the left hand side 8, on the right hand side only 2. So this side also we have to make it 8. How it is possible? This 2 should be multiplied with 4 so that it become 8, isn't it? So on the right hand side we have to multiply with 4. Okay, so that we can do in the equation. Then we have to multiply the right hand side which contain hydrogen atom with 4. Okay, so when we are multiply here with 4, 4 into 2, 8 hydrogen atoms. So the number of hydrogen atom also becomes equal on both sides. So again we can check once again. Iron 3 in the left hand side, in the right hand side also 3. Then hydrogen 4 into 2, 8. Here also 4 into 2, 8. Then oxygen 4 into 1, 4, here 4. Okay, so the number of all atoms becomes equal on both sides. Now this equation is a balanced equation. Now in the last step, we can rewrite this equation again without these boxes. 3Fe plus 4H2O gives Fe3O4 plus 4H2. This is the balanced equation of the given chemical reaction. So these are the steps involved in the balancing of chemical reaction. Second example is zinc metal react with hydrochloric acid to produce zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. This is the chemical reaction given. We have to balance the equation of this reaction. So the first step, we have to write the weighed equation of this reaction. So for that we have to identify which are the reactants and which are the product. In this reaction, which are the reactants? Zinc metal react with hydrochloric acid. So zinc and hydrochloric acid are the reactants. And which are the product? Zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. So first we have to write the weighed equation. That is the first step. We have to write the weighed equation. Zinc plus hydrochloric acid gives zinc chloride plus hydrogen. Then in the second step we have to convert it into chemical equation using the symbols and formulae of reactants and product. Zinc, the symbol is Zn, plus hydrochloric acid HCl. Then zinc chloride, the formula is ZnCl2 plus hydrogen H2. So this is the skeletal equation of the given chemical reaction. Okay, that is the second step. Now we have to put these reactants and product in boxes. Then don't make any changes inside these boxes. Outside the boxes only we can add numbers to balance this chemical reaction. Now in the next step we have to list the number of atoms of different elements present in the skeletal equation. So for that we have to draw a table like this. First column element, second column number of atoms on the left hand side, third column number of atoms on the right hand side. So the elements present are zinc, hydrogen and chlorine. Then how many zinc atoms are there on the left hand side? Only one zinc atom, so we have to write one. Then in the right hand side also only one zinc atom, so we have to write one. Then the second element is hydrogen. In the right hand side, in the left hand side only one, so here we can write one. And in the right hand side two hydrogen atoms are there. Then chlorine, in the left hand side one and in the right hand side two. So the number of zinc atoms are already balanced, but the numbers of hydrogen and chlorine are not balanced. So we have to balance them. So in the next step, that is step 4, we have to select the formula which contain more number of atoms. Here zinc chloride is the formula which contain more number of atom. Then we have to select which element contain more number of atom. Chlorine contain more number of atoms. So first we can balance the number of chlorine atom. Okay. Now again we have drawn the table, then the element we are going to balance is chlorine. Chlorine in the left hand side only one chlorine atom and in the right hand side two chlorine atom. So left hand side one and right hand side two. So we have to balance the numbers equal. We have to make the numbers equal. For that in the left hand side we have to multiply with 2. Okay, the left hand side we have to multiply with 2. So as a result, the number of chlorine atom on the left hand side becomes equal to that of right hand side. So where we have to multiply with 2? In the left hand side. So that we have to write in the equation also. So the equation becomes So the left hand side we are multiplying with 2. As a result, the number of chlorine atom in the LHS becomes 2. In the RHS also it is 2. So the number of chlorine atom becomes equal on both sides. Next, which element we have to balance? The zinc. It is already balanced. Here one zinc atom, here also one zinc atom. So its number is already balanced. The next element is hydrogen. Here 2 hydrogen atom. And when we are multiply here with 2, the number of hydrogen atom also becomes 2. So the number of hydrogen atom becomes equal on both sides. Here it is 2, here also it is 2. Okay. So in this equation, the number of atoms of all elements become equal on both sides. So this equation is the balanced equation. So we can again write this equation without these boxes. Zn plus 2HCl gives ZnCl2 plus H2. The left hand side one zinc atom, right hand side also one zinc atom. In the left hand side 2 hydrogen atom, in the right hand side also 2 hydrogen atom. In the left hand side 2 chlorine atom, right hand side also 2 chlorine atom. So the numbers of all atoms becomes equal. So this is the balanced equation. Okay. Now these are some points to remember while balancing an equation. First point is that the number of atom on both sides should be equal. After balancing the equation, we have to check that the number of atoms on both sides of the equation are equal. Then the second point is that do not change the subscripts. When we are writing Fe3O4, 3 is the subscript of iron atom. Then 4 is the subscript of oxygen. So while balancing an equation, we are not supposed to change these numbers. For that we are drawing a box. So inside the box we are not supposed to make any changes. For example, suppose this is the given equation, H2 plus O2 gives H2O. Here the number of hydrogen atom on the left hand side is 2, on the right hand side also 2. So its number is equal on both sides. Oxygen here 2 on the left hand side and on the right hand side only 1. So there is a chance for writing 2 here in order to make the numbers equal. You are not supposed to do like that. This is wrong. Okay. Then how can we balance this equation? H2 plus O2 gives H2O. Okay. We are not supposed to write any numbers here. Then here 2 oxygen atoms are there. Here only 1 oxygen atom. So to make it equal, we have to multiply with 2. On this side, we have to multiply with 2. So these numbers we are writing here is known as coefficients. Okay. They are known as coefficients. If you are not writing any numbers, that means the coefficient is 1. Here the coefficient is 1, here also the coefficient is 1. But here to make the number of oxygen atom equal, we are multiplying with 2. So here the coefficient is 2. Okay. Now when we are multiplying here with 2, here 2 oxygen atoms are there, here also 2 oxygen atom. So its number become equal on both sides. Now when we are multiplying here with 2, what about the number of hydrogen atom? 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen atoms are there. But here only 2 hydrogen atom. So again, we have to make it equal. For that, here we have to multiply with 2. On the left hand side, we have to multiply with 2. So here also 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen atom. Here also 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen atom. Okay. Now this equation is balanced. The third factor is that in some cases, for example here BaCl2 plus Na2SO4 gives BaSO4 plus NaCl. We have to balance this equation. Here SO4 is present in the reactant side, like that SO4 is present in the product side also. In such cases, when we are listing the elements, we have to write barium. It is one element, then chlorine, then sodium. Then SO4, it is present on both sides. So we can write it as SO4 itself. We don't want to split them into sulfur and oxygen. We can write it as SO4. Okay. How many SO4 are there in the left hand side? Like that, how many SO4 are there in the right hand side? That we can write here. Here, barium only 1 in the left hand side. Then in the right hand side also 1. Then chlorine here 2. Here 1, then sodium here 2 and here only 1, then SO4 here 1, here also 1. Okay, so in such cases, if SO4, like that, some group of atoms will be present on both sides, we don't want to split them, we can write them as such. Okay, then here we can balance this equation. The number of barium atoms are already balanced. Then chlorine, two atoms are there in the right, left hand side, but here only one atom. So there we have to multiply with 2 to make it 2. Okay, so 1 into 2 equal 2. So the product which contain chlorine atom should be multiplied with 2. So here we have to multiply with 2. Okay, then sodium, it in the left hand side 2 and in the right hand side only 1. So there also we have to multiply with 2, but already we have multiplied with 2. So the number of sodium atom also becomes 2 here, isn't it? So we don't want to multiply again. Only 1, 2 is enough. Okay, we have to multiply with only 1, 2. So 2 into NaCl means 2Na and 2Cl. So their numbers becomes equal on both sides. Then SO4, 1 in the left hand side, 1 in the right hand side. So its numbers number is also equal on both sides. Now this equation is balanced. Okay. Hope it is clear for all of you. Practice it, okay?